representing San Bernardino, California. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Michael Mook Mitchell Jr.
My name is Michael Mook Mitchell Jr. and I'm from San Bernardino, California. I went from a backyard brawler to an amateur mixed martial artist to kickboxing the son of a legend, Anderson Silva's son, Khalil Silva. Fighters rep 15 at the Commerce Casino September 3rd, 2022. Will forever be sketched in my memory as the day I took on the son of a spider. My first taste of competition in 2022 came in March when I competed in a point kickboxing match. I decided at the beginning of the year that 2022 would be the year I transitioned out of fighting in street beefs and start working on my amateur fighting career. I felt that a PKB was the perfect way to warm up and get ready mentally for sanctioned fights. I faced a taller opponent with a kicking base. I didn't notice at the time, but fighting someone with that style and height was beneficial to prepare me for the fight with Silva in the future. I got my hand raised, but I was far from satisfied with my performance. I felt my cardio was gonna have to be a lot better if I was gonna start competing in these upcoming shows. My coach told me about a few upcoming shows that I could fight in, one being the MMA fight in King of the Cage in June in Reno, Nevada. Now this would be my first sanctioned bout, and would signify my evolution from backyard fighter to amateur mixed martial artist. I knew that if I was going to be stepping up in competition, I would also have to step up in my training. I have an amazing team at Engage Combat Training, and they started helping me to prepare for what was to come. One thing I added to my training was long hikes at elevation and hill sprints. I learned a lot about pacing. So I kept training hard, getting stronger, faster, and sharper. The hardest thing I had to get used to was cutting weight. This was the first time I had to cut weight. I was 175 after the PKBs and I had to get down to 155 pounds. For someone who's never cut weight before, it was difficult, but my team had my back. I was getting more and more confident each day. All my training done and my weight down, it was time to take care of business. The paperwork, photo shoots, stare downs were all things I had to get used to, but I enjoyed the experience. All the formal things out of the way, it was time to get in the cage.
He's a freestyle mixed martial artist representing Engage Combat Sports. He comes to the King of the Cage Steel for his debut fight tonight. Fighting out of and representing San Bernardino, California. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Michael Mook Mitchell Jr.
I knew my opponent was a grappler and wanted to take me down as soon as he could. Right out the gate, he rushed in to hold me up against the cage, and to his credit, he felt strong in the tie-up. He was able to get me down a couple of times, but I kept getting up. We worked a lot of defense in camp, and a lot of it was muscle memory by the time I got in there. He kept fighting hard for that takedown, and even though I kept getting up, it doesn't look good on the judges' scorecards to be the one defending the whole time. One thing I'm known for is staying calm and being patient. So it was important for me not to panic. It was important to look for or create opportunities. As the round went on, I could feel him gradually fatiguing. Once I was able to get space, I put the pressure on him. He went for one more panic takedown, I sprawled and began the ground and pound. I delivered hard lefts and rights, and one perfectly placed right hand behind the ear brought him down for the finish. At 2 minutes and 44 seconds into the first round, the ref called the fight off. And with that, I was officially an amateur mixed martial artist with a first round TKO victory. With a successful outing at King of the Cage complete, it was now time to get back to training and plan my next move. I've had my eyes on a kickboxing organization called Fighters Rep for some time, and my coach said I should register. Even though my heart is set in MMA, I decided to register. And not long after that, I got the call to face the legendary Anderson Silva's son, Khalil Silva. Now I, just like any other martial artist on the planet, am a huge Anderson Silva fan, and the prospect of fighting his talented son was an opportunity I couldn't pass up.
Yo, September 3rd. Fighters Rep 15 at the Commerce Casino. Watch me take on son of a legend. Big fight for me, I got tickets on deck.
So I started intensifying my training. I began running at least 5 miles a day, doing a circuit, and then some PM classes. I also had to adjust my diet, which was the hardest part. I like to eat. I really put a lot into training camp. I wanted to show my friends and family that with hard work, we could do great things. And now it was time to put all my training, all my hard work, and all my sacrifice on display against my biggest opponent yet. There are a few things in life that can make you literally feel every emotion at the same time. Fighting in front of a crowd is one of them. Excitement and fear. Confidence and doubt, gratitude, happiness, anger. Literally every emotion gets jumbled into one energy and you can either use it or it will use you. This was the first time my friends and family were all able to come out to one of my fights. My lady, my brothers, cousins, uncles, friends, coworkers were all in the crowd cheering, and I fed off of their energy. Once the fight starts, all those emotions go away and it's time to focus. My game plan was to cut the ring off, land my shots, and maintain a range I'm comfortable at, not too far, not too close. I wanted to pressure him and land punches when he's backing up. I also wanted to throw leg kicks. Khalil was tough and landed some big shots of his own. He's a tall striker with lethal head kicks.
But I stood my ground and fired back.
I started getting his timing down and started getting more confident.
Silva trying a little showboat action with those hands.
Side kick from Silva. Mitchell is doing things right, man. He's showing things.
Oh, jump kicking. And Mitchell's scoring effectively.
Yeah.
And Silva now is trying to push the action.
There he goes.
In the last moments of the last round, we decided to bite down on our mouthpieces and started swinging.
Silva trying to turn it on, but Mitchell fires back.
Mitchell's always in the fight.
And that is it. Wow, what a good rally to close off that third and final round.
And with that, the match was over, and we earned each other's respect.
And a level of respect. Look at the respect they paid each other.
Beautiful. It was an honor facing a fellow humble warrior in Khalil Silva.
And then Mitchell was always there. Always there in the fight. Always doing something. Kick, a punch, a spin kick.
Getting my hand raised that night meant so much to me. It wasn't so much about beating my opponent. My goal was to inspire my family and friends and show them that we could do anything and have anything we want if we work hard. Seeing everyone come out to support made all the training, stress, and sacrifices worth it. I train for myself to grow, but I fight for them to inspire. This is what it's all about. I'm blessed, and I plan to keep making them proud.
I mean, you guys just turned up lately. What was going through your mind in that last part of the third round? What was it with your fireworks?
We came out here with a victory. My boy Silva was son. He tried to turn it up in the third round, but it just wasn't enough. You know what I'm saying? My boy Mook came out with the victory. We outside. Hey, what's next from here? Sky's the limit. We going up. What up, Mook? Hey, see you, baby.
All right, Mook. I know your big head is all elated right now, but you got a lot of work to do. So get your ass back in the gym Monday.
That's right, check the spider out. Spider, do you out?
Yeah, if you can.
That's right.
I'm so fucking proud.
I finally see you now. What a big ass motherfucker.
Hey, man, I'm happy for you. Congrats.
Thank you.
That's right. Put that work on it.
Put a good time, man.
Let's get a group picture.
Come on, let's get a picture.
Another group picture. Got a camera.
So far, 2022 has been an eventful year. I reached a few milestones in my career as a martial artist and got my biggest victory to date.
That's a hard one. The kid did his thing. I was surprised, man, by the level shown.
In a short time, I went from fighting in the dirt to lights, camera, action. I appreciate the experience and I'll remember this for the rest of my life, but I still have lots of work to do. I still have goals to reach and growing to do, both in and out the ring. My only promise is that no matter what, win, lose, or draw, I will always strive to be a better version of myself than I was yesterday.